Dogs have been used in battle since men tamed them for the first time. Dogs were present in ancient Egyptian armies, ancient Greek armies, Assyrian, Babylonian and Persian armies, but it's among the Roman battle formation that dogs, especially the famous Canis Pugnax, were most effective. Let's discover together how this dog shaped history and how it was used in war. The Canis Pugnax. The Canis Pugnax, from Latin dog of war, the most common dog used in war by the Romans, is now an extinct species, but genetically in between the modern day Mastino Napoletano breed and the Cane Corso breed. It was 80 cm tall at the withers and it weighed between 60 to 100 kg. The bite of this dog applies a force of 50 kg per square centimeter. For comparison, an African lion has a bite force of 45 kg per square centimeter. It was so dangerous that the Romans gave these dogs soldier titles and inserted them in specific branches of the military called auxilia, the support units. The Canis Pugnax was trained in specific schools for gladiators in the city of Capua. It was trained to recognize and distinguish between friend and foe, to accept food only from allies, to attack only when asked, and to disintegrate the opponent. To make them fearless in front of men, Romans used to feed these dogs with prisoners of war still alive. How was the Canis Pugnax used in battle? The Canis Pugnax was used in many ways. The Canis Pugnax was used at the beginning of a Roman soldier formation as a vanguard, 200 meters away from it, to smell the presence of the enemy and avoid ambushes. The Roman soldiers walked for 35 kilometers a day on average, and during the night, the soldiers were building provisory tents to sleep. The Canis Pugnax was useful to spot enemies during the night. The dogs would either bark to wake up the Roman soldiers or either attack the enemy. And I'd like to point out that these dogs were black, so they were invisible in the night, and therefore the enemies could not see them, just hear them approaching furiously. In battle, the Canis Pugnax had a thick leather armor, or lamellar armor made with iron, impenetrable by arrows. Often the Romans would equip them with a collar full of spikes, or blades, to attack the enemy infantry, or they would equip them with a collar of burning torches, or two buckets of boiling oil, to use them to set enemy villages on fire. Moreover, they were very fast and small compared to horses, and therefore they were very difficult to hit with arrows and javelins, and impossible to catch because the Romans cut their ears and tails so that nobody could grab them and hold them to hit them. During an attack, the Romans would simply order hundreds of dogs at a time to swarm towards the enemy formations. Imagine hundreds or thousands of dogs set on fire or full of blades coming towards you. Yes, that's very scary. And they were useful not only to create chaos among enemy lines, but also to take down enemy cavalry and to attack the enemy while retreating, to not allow the enemy to regroup and reorganize its army. The Canis Pugnax was also used in hunting, to chase criminals in forests. They were used in arenas like in the Colosseum of Rome in fights against gladiators or other animals, and they were used also to protect the houses of rich people, the patricians. By the way, did you know that the sign "Beware of Dog" starts in this period because the rich people would put a sign on the fences of their villas with written "Cave Canem"? The Canis Pugnax has been present in almost every battle recorded throughout Roman history, and it was essential in the conquest and expansion of the Roman Empire. The most famous case where the Canis Pugnax was used is in the year 231 BC in the island of Sardinia, where the local inhabitants used guerrilla warfare to defeat Roman troops in the island and gain independence. The Roman consul from Rome, back then, to stop the riot, ordered the release of thousands of dogs in the island to find the rioters and eliminate them. And yes, all the island was canvassed. The rioters were eliminated, and the island became Roman again, with few soldiers and mostly dogs. And that's not all, because 2200 years afterwards, dogs keep being an essential part of the police units, army, special forces, and not only of Italy, but of the entire world.